Round three highlights of the Australian PGA Championship from the RACV Royal Pines Resort on the Gold Coast. We start with the Warragul Wizard on the eighth, Cameron Percy for birdie.
Straight up the hill. Not a huge break of this one. Great for pace and line right in the bottom.
In the final pairing today, David McKenzie starting the day at 7-under. This is his tee shot.
Just hung a little further right than he wanted to. Needs a little bit of ground help. Gets it through the rough and through the fringe. And, well, a fantastic shot, leaving himself an uphiller for birdie on the second, the par three.
Which he went on to make Rickie Fowler for birdie on the second.
Down the hill, a slippery sliding left to righter. And make no mistake, his eye was in.
Back to McKenzie on the fifth for another birdie attempt.
From long range, little elevation change there, a little up and then it's down, it's left to right all the way.
Come on. Well done to David McKenzie, who moved to 9-under. We move on to the seventh hole. This is the approach of the American Rickie Fowler.
Currently on 8-under par, just with a short iron, some kind of wedge. Trying to get some spin, it doesn't react, it's still a good shot. Almost wiped the flag out, leaving himself a downhill. You can see it's shiny there, it's down grain and fast. And in she goes.
Fowler moved to 9-under at this stage. Steven Jeffress, a local Queenslander, on the eighth hole for birdie.
Another uphiller. Not a lot of break in it, and he knows these greens like the back of his hand.
David McKenzie, his approach on the eighth.
Just a short little jolt. Take a little spin there and just release that. You can see how firm and fast these greens are becoming.
We move forward to the 15th hole. A par five, which is an eagle opportunity. And that's what Michael Wright had.
Just a gentle right to left or across this green. The ball's got eyes. Straight in, an eagle three.
Moved Michael to 5-under the card. Back to the 13th hole. A man that was 4-under. Jack Wilson, the Victorian.
Up the hill, not a big breaker. A lot of the greens here don't break too much, and Jackie Wilson says.
On the 14th hole, Paul with a long across the green attempt for birdie.
Gentle left to righter for the big guy.
In the side door, and he moved to 6-under. Back to Michael Wright on the 18th hole.
On the left-hand side of the fairway, an ideal angle. The wind slightly out of the left-hand side. It's a friendly flag position today, frontish right on this 18th. And, well, even I could get that one.
Michael hold that birdie to finish the day at 6-under and keep himself right in contention. The Masters champion, Adam Scott, on the 12th for eagle.
Down the hill, fairly fast. In fact, very fast. Starting to turn a little left, wasn't to be, but still a very good birdie four on a par five nevertheless.
On the par five, 15th hole, this is the second shot of the Newcastle export Nathan Green.
Trying to thread it through that gap at the front of this green. Needs a little bit of help here. Oh, he gets it and releases straight up this green. Keep going. It could be a albatross too. Little sloppy. He left himself a metre for his
and
eagle.
Knocked that in for eagle to move to 5-under the card. Adam Scott for eagle on the same hole. Starts at topside. It doesn't come back down, but Scott obviously makes the resultant birdie to move to 10-under. The American Rickie Fowler, 6-under at this point on the 16th hole for birdie.
Not a lot of break in this one on the par three, 16th, and straight in the middle.
And on the 18th hole, in front of his local crowd, and they came to watch him, Adam Scott, to finish off with a par. No problems for the 2013 US Masters champion. He leads by three shots. He'll be paired with Rickie Fowler in the final pairing tomorrow. McKenzie, Wright, Jeffress and Leishman all in the mix.